Good morning. My name is Artur, and I welcome you to the first talk of the first session of the first day of the second open source KubeSat workshop. Okay, this was the icebreaker. So, when you start a workshop, usually it's a good idea to introduce the goal and the objective of this workshop to let you know why you're here. But since you are already here, maybe it's an even better idea to turn this into a question and ask, why are you here? So, I would like to hear from you. What is the reason that you come here? Yeah. And in particular, what do you love to get out of this workshop? Maybe two or three opinions.
Hi, my name is Pablo, and I am here to try to use this amazing community of open source and CubeSats to build a CubeSat mission fully open source, not only in the platform, but also during the development, to try to achieve a scientific mission. So I will have a work group, so don't hesitate to join me if you are interested.
Send this
okay.
One. Oh, this one is cooler.
Careful, though.
Who wants to receive this one?
Or just throw it in the crowd.
Yeah, over there.
Okay, good.
He was checking something in his
microphone.
Ah, ooh. Okay, so hi. No, quite for the same reason. I'm fond of open source. I'm fond of CubeSats. So, of course, I'm interested. What to say more?
Awesome. Good. Very good.
Yes.
You see, it's going to be very interactive.
Hey, guys. I see.
Okay. We're starting a space team in Bahrain. It's a very new field there. And we want to know more about CubeSats and how they function. And we're building a small CubeSat, an open source one, of course.
Okay. Good, okay. Thanks for sharing your feedback so openly. And yeah, open is the thing of this workshop. So it's the open source CubeSat workshop. So the question might be, there's already so many space conferences and even a handful of CubeSat workshops that you could attend. Why do we have this one here? Why did we have the open source CubeSat workshop? And the answer to this is actually quite simple. None of the other conferences or workshops, they have any focus on open source. They have no session dedicated to it. So here we have one now. For 2 days, today and tomorrow, we talk exclusively about open source, CubeSats, and space. Which brings me to the next question, why open source space? Why not just continue as is? Well, if you sit here, then hopefully you already have this kind of mindset that sharing and collaborating is something that is very essential in order to make progress. And for this, you need open source. But not only this. I think that space exploration as a whole, this is something for all of mankind, humanity, I mean. Should not be something reserved to a few people or companies or even countries. So everyone should have the chance to participate. We need a lot of different kinds of people from different backgrounds for space exploration, and not only space engineers. And the good thing is that already there's a lot of people, almost everyone, has an interest for space, no matter how young or old they are or where they are from. So let's give those people a chance to take their part in space exploration, and not only by watching science fiction movies. So, this brings me now to the concrete goals of this workshop. So obviously, it's to promote the idea of open source, the philosophy of open source, bring to space exploration. And in order to do so, it's very essential that you have a community and you build networks of people. So this is a picture from last year's workshop. I wonder, just I'm curious, who in the audience here recognizes themselves on this picture? Okay, good. You see there's already some networks forming. And just as a side note, this is a very blurry picture. So we need better photographers. Yeah, please, if you have a good camera, take pictures and submit them. And yeah, it's open source, and open source is all about sharing, right? And cute rabbits. So let me now share with you just some key figures of this workshop. We have this is 2 days, around 20 talks. We have almost 30 countries represented, and we had 120 registration to fill up here this room. I heard that some of the people, the participants, are still stuck in Frankfurt because of the storm that was there yesterday, but they will come eventually to here. And yeah, so this is the space that we have today for this here at this venue. And so where are we actually? We are at ESA's Space Science Center. So here is where data from the Gaia mission is collected and from other science missions. And so it's quite fitting to have then the theme of this year's workshop, Open Space Science. And so Fernando, he will replace Danny Lennon, who could not make it this morning. And he will tell you a bit more about what they do here in ESAC. But the theme is actually a bit more than that. It's basically the question how we can get the scientific community who might not have a lot of knowledge about space technology and CubeSats, how we can get them involved in space exploration, for example, by providing an open source CubeSat platform. Okay, and obviously all of this would not be possible if you were not here. And also due to the effort of a handful of people. So on the top, we have the technical committee, Redouan, Pieros and Mantos from Libre Space Foundation. Pieros, unfortunately, cannot be here today. And then myself. And we have the local organizing committee, Fernando, Marcos, Julio, Jorge, and Coral. I didn't have a picture of Coral, but you met her outside. She gave you the badge. The badge, yeah. And if you have any question, then during the workshop, any kind of question, just approach any one of us. So it's an open source workshop, but the workshop itself is also open source, meaning that you did not have to pay anything to come here. But on the other hand, you have to bring everything by yourself. We don't hand out pencils, papers, or bags. And worse, you have to pay your own lunch. Welcome to the world of open source. And just a side note, we also use exclusively open source tools for organizing this workshop, except perhaps for this infrastructure laptop that we have here and that we will burn afterwards. So just a quick look through the program. We have talks. So a talk is 12 minutes of presentations, then followed by 8 minutes of an interactive feedback session. So we want to make this presentation not for the audience, but with the audience. So we don't want to have this Q&A ping pong, but rather we want to have an open and constructive discussion about this topic. Then we have the post and demo session that will be outside. Then we have a pitch session today. And this is for everyone who could not make a talk. Actually, it's open to anyone. You can come here on the stage and have about 2 to 3 minutes, and you can...
1 minute and a half, right?
Depends on how many people will come up, but you can come up on the stage, and then you can present an idea or your mission to everyone. Then we have work groups, and the work groups are composed, so you form groups. Some of the topics have been already announced on the website. We also support or encourage to have ad hoc work groups where we can discuss about a certain topic. And then we have all the usual things that you expect from a workshop. But you will get more information once we reach all of these points. this is my last slide. Just as a kind of breaking news, we were contacted prior to the workshop by these two open access journals, Software X and Hardware X. So open access means you can download, anyone can download them for free. It's just when you publish a paper, you have to pay some processing fee. And these journals, they offered us to publish papers resulting out of this workshop free of charge. And I think this is a great idea and a great opportunity to promote it even to a greater audience. So that's all from me for now. And I hand over to Redwan, who will chair you to the rest of this welcome session, which will get much more interesting from now on. Ah, there's already a question. OK. Yes, that's true. We post everything online. Yeah.
So the slide will be available after. Yeah.
For the pitch, you can bring slides, but you still have to fit to the.
We'll discuss that later. Don't worry. Okay. Thank you, Artur. Thank you, Artur. So don't look at the screen. I'm red. So today I wear my color, my name. I'm so glad to be here because it's the second time we're doing this. And I'm so glad to see many new faces and faces from last year too who made it until Madrid. That's cool. So what you don't know, maybe you already know about Artur, is that he knows the full spectrum of success. He had one very successful CubeSat mission and one very unsuccessful CubeSat mission. And he knows that sharing knowledge is important. And if you don't share knowledge, knowledge is lost. So that's why we're here today. And